SpaceX is gearing up for its busiest Falcon Heavy mega rocket launch yet, and now, thanks to the US Air Force and NASA. The rocket, just shy of 230 feet tall, has been the tallest rocket and most powerful rocket since the Saturn V rockets last used in the Apollo space program in 1973. It consists of three boosters instead of one and fires all of its 27 engines simultaneously, producing more than 5 million pounds of thrust at liftoff. Per SpaceX's official confirmation, a quick look inspection of static fire telemetry has indicated that the company's Falcon Heavy rocket is ready for its next launch in less than 3 months, a milestone that could also allow both flight-proven side boosters to tie SpaceX's own record for booster turnaround. When the next SpaceX Falcon Heavy launches on the 24th of June, Monday, from NASA's historic Pad 39A at the Kennedy Space Center in Florida, the heavy lift rocket will be carrying 24 different satellites for the Air Force's Space Test Program 2 mission. If you're wondering what two dozen satellites look like inside a Falcon Heavy nose cone, wonder no more. In a Twitter post Tuesday, June 18th, the Air Force Space and Missile Systems Center, in charge of the STP-2 mission, showed just how the 24 satellites are stacked inside the payload fairing. The 3,700 kilogram, 8,157 pounds, integrated payload stack for STP-2 has been completed, Air Force officials wrote in the post. Have a look before it blasts off on the first Department of Defense Falcon Heavy launch. In this video, Engineering Today will discuss SpaceX Falcon Heavy mega rocket, which goes vertical ahead of planned Monday launch. Why Elon Musk says this Monday's Falcon Heavy flight will be SpaceX's most difficult launch ever. Let's get into details. The STP-2 mission is scheduled to launch sometime during a 4-hour window that opens Monday night at 11:30 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. Coincidentally, on top of being Falcon Heavy's first scheduled night launch, STP-2 has now also marked the massive rocket's first nighttime static fire. During this critical test, Falcon Heavy briefly ignites all 27 of its three boosters' Merlin 1Ds and throttles the engine up to full thrust, much like airlines sometimes set their brakes and throttle up before attempting to take off. The difference between Falcon Heavy and passenger aircraft is nevertheless rather significant, given that Falcon Heavy produces 15 times more thrust of an A380 aircraft, the world's most powerful mass-produced passenger aircraft, at liftoff, 22,820 kilonewtons. As such, not only does SpaceX's dedicated pre-launch static fire fully test the rocket's health, but the same procedure is essentially repeated in the seconds before clamp release during an actual orbital launch attempt. After those critical tests, flight-proven Falcon boosters are subjected to the less stringent few-second static fire SpaceX performs at the launch pad 3 to 7 days before a given launch. With Falcon Heavy Flight 3, the rocket's center core, upper stage, and payload fairing are all brand new, fresh from either SpaceX's Hawthorne factory or McGregor acceptance testing. However, both side cores, Block 5 boosters B1052 and B1053, are flight-proven, having successfully completed their first launches and landings on April 11th, less than 70 days ago. Set by regular old Falcon 9 boosters, SpaceX's current record for booster turnaround time is 71 days, set in June of 2018, while the Block 5 upgrade's record stands at 74 days, set in October of 2018. If Falcon Heavy's STP-2 launch holds strong on June 24th, B1052 and B1053 will simultaneously tie SpaceX's Block 5 turnaround record. This would be accomplished despite the added pressure from the U.S. Air Force's decision to use STP-2 as a sort of dress rehearsal for certifying all flight-proven commercial rockets, an honor that likely added extra work, oversight, and scrutiny to the process of refurbishing and relaunching B-1052 and B-1053. It will be the third Falcon Heavy launch for SpaceX, but the first to carry more than one satellite at a time. The first Falcon Heavy mission, a test flight in February 2018, carried a Tesla Roadster owned by SpaceX CEO Elon Musk and Starman, a mannequin dressed in an official SpaceX spacesuit. The Roadster and Starman are still out there in deep space. SpaceX successfully recovered its two side boosters, which simultaneously touched back down to Earth like a kind of choreographed rocket routine. But the main booster botched its landing on a drone ship and crashed in the Atlantic Ocean, which Musk said was due to some of its return engines failing to ignite during re-entry. A single massive satellite, the 14,241-pound, 6,460-kilograms, Arabsat 6A, launched atop SpaceX's second Falcon Heavy on April 11th of this year. Initially, things were looking good with the successful launch of SpaceX Falcon Heavy, and SpaceX even managed to land all three first-stage boosters this time around. However, a few days later, the company announced that they'd lost the center booster at sea after a set of rough waves. The two first-stage side boosters used to launch Arabsat 6A will be reused again on this Falcon Heavy SDP-2 mission, SpaceX has said. The launch is a test run for the Falcon Heavy for the Air Force in efforts by SpaceX to get its heavy lift rocket certification for future national security missions. This time, SpaceX updated Falcon Heavy center core B-1057's planned drone ship landing site from a brief 40 kilometers, 25 miles, to more than 1,240 kilometers, 770 miles, off the coast of Florida. SpaceX set its current record for recovery distance less than 3 months ago during Falcon Heavy's commercial launch debut, in which Block 5 center core, B-1055, landed nearly 970 kilometers, or 600 miles, offshore on drone ship Of Course I Still Love You. If all goes well, B-1057, the second finished Block 5 center core, will absolutely crush its predecessor's record, implying that the booster will likely be subjected to SpaceX's most difficult re-entry and recovery yet. The 24 satellites of the SpaceX Falcon Heavy SDP-2 mission comprise a diverse group of spacecraft built by NASA, the U.S. military, National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, student teams from universities. SpaceX includes a NASA atomic clock, a satellite to test green spacecraft propellant, and the LightSail 2 solar sail for the Planetary Society, among others. Using the new technology developed by NASA that aims to make it easier to navigate to Mars. The Deep Space Atomic Clock, DSAC, could be a big key for unlocking navigation in space. Thanks to improved tech, this atomic clock is both small and stable enough to send into space. Right now, scientists must send a signal from ground-based atomic clocks to a traveling spacecraft before waiting for the ping to return so they can determine the spacecraft's distance and speed. With the DSAC, the signal only has to go one way. Instead of constantly bouncing back and forth, this allows the spacecraft to calculate its own trajectory, just like a GPS does. With planned missions to Mars, the DCSC's one-year mission will help researchers develop a more precise tracking system for future missions, which one day may include astronauts. NASA's Space Environment Testbed, SET, satellite will also be aboard the SpaceX Falcon Heavy. It aims to study how other satellites are affected by space radiation, which can interrupt communications with satellites and even affect the electronics we use here on Earth. The Planetary Society, which is a SpaceX exploration nonprofit, is also attempting another solar sail experiment following the SpaceX Falcon Heavy's launch. Their LightSail 2 craft hopes to be the first spacecraft to orbit the Earth propelled only by solar light. Though the first LightSail experienced a few technical glitches during its flight, overall it was a successful trip. To successfully complete SDP-2, the upper stage will be subjected to 4 separate upper stage engine burns, 3 separate deployment orbits, a final propulsive passivation maneuver, and a total mission duration of over 6 hours. It will likely be SpaceX's most technically challenging launch ever. SpaceX added that the ability to carry many satellites at once, as well as launch with used boosters, are key milestones for the mission. STP-2 multi-manifest launch will demonstrate the capabilities of the SpaceX Falcon Heavy launch vehicle and provide critical data supporting certification for future national security space launch missions, SpaceX officials said. In addition, the Air Force Space and Missile Systems Center will use this mission as a pathfinder for the development of mission assurance policies and procedures related to the reuse of launch vehicle boosters. SpaceX regularly reuses the first stage boosters of its smaller Falcon 9 rockets, as well as its uncrewed Dragon cargo ships that deliver NASA cargo to the International Space Station. SpaceX has been steadily developing reusable rocket technology to lower the cost of spaceflight. Finally, while 24 satellites may seem like a lot, SpaceX has actually launched more at the same time on its Falcon 9 rockets. Last year, the company launched 64 tiny satellites at the same time as part of a rideshare mission brokered by the company Spaceflight. Just last month, SpaceX launched the first 60 of its Starlink internet satellites to lay the foundation of a constellation aimed to number in the thousands of satellites. As mentioned, the STP-2 mission will be among the most challenging launches in SpaceX history, with four separate upper stage engine burns. In addition, the U.S. Air Force plans to reuse side boosters from the Arabsat 6A Falcon Heavy launch, recovered after a return to launch site landing, making it the first reused Falcon Heavy ever flown for the U.S. Air Force. The U.S. Air Force has already certified SpaceX Falcon Heavy to fly national security payloads, with SpaceX snagging its first military mission for the rocket last summer, a $130 million deal to launch an Air Force Space Command satellite sometime in 2020. But this is the vehicle's first launch carrying a government payload, so the Air Force is paying close attention to how the vehicle performs during its launch. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.